Nigerians are the problems of Nigerians living in Ghana. Ghanaians, they are not the problem Nigeria are facing in Republic of Ghana. Nigerians, they are the problems to themselves. Guys, that is what we will be deliberating today. Okay, my people, you know, guys, in my previous video, I always say there is nothing but the truth. That is what we will be discussing in this live broadcast. Maria Omo Family TV. To my old subscribers, you are welcome. May God bless you. To my new subscribers, you are welcome. May God bless you. To my viewers and lovers all over the world, big kisses to you all. Guys, trust me, I am not taking any of you for granted, because without you guys, I don't think I will be here. Okay, guys, trust me, I so much appreciate you all, and I love you guys with the love of God. Okay, my adorable people, in today's video, guys, there is a video I will be dropping along this video. Before I will drop that video, I really want to talk to my fellow Nigeria. I want to talk to them, because what they are doing is not really called for. It's not nice. I don't know what they gain every time rubbishy that nation called Nigeria, rubbishy our youth. I don't really know what they gain from it. Okay, my people. So, my adorable people, you can see our brothers and our sister in Ghana, they left Nigeria for their greener pasture, my people. Just the way we left Nigeria to Europe. Okay, my people. So, to overrent a house in Ghana now is very, very, very difficult, my people. To rent just one room where they can lay their head is very difficult. In short, it's not even possible now. Because before they will give you that accommodation, definitely your landlord, just like Europe, you understand, just like Europe, you know, if you don't have documents in Europe, to get apartment is just the grace of God, my people. You understand? But when you have documents, trust me, you are working to get apartment is very, very easy. That same method, that is the method Ghanaians are using in their country today, which me so much appreciate that method. That is the reason why our nation today is just so, anybody that comes to that country today, we rent a house in that country without not even, no stress, not at all. In short, they don't even know what you do for a living. They don't know where you are coming from. If you are an ex-criminal, if you are a witch and wizard, they don't even care. What they care about, bring that money and show you the environment, show you the room. Here is your room. They don't care to know what you are doing for a living, which is very bad. Ghanaians, they don't do their own like that. Before they will give you accommodation, a Ghanaian citizen is going to sign a surety that will say, yes, this Nigerian person is really genuine, he's a good person, this is what he's doing for a living, before they will give you accommodation to stay. Do you guys know why? Those are bad Nigerians that is just spoiling the name of Nigeria all over everywhere. How can you acquire a Ghana passport for €1,000 if not a criminal you want to use that passport for? If not for bad thing you want to use that passport for, you will acquire passport for €1,000, because you know what you want to do with that passport. You know you are not going to use that passport to do good things. You want to use it to constitute nuisance. That is the reason why you just pay that €1,000 to acquire that passport. And the most stupid part of you, you don't even keep it to yourself. Do you think Ghanaians, they are like us? Ghanaians, they are just like white people. Their mind is so open. They don't have secrets. Ghanaians don't have that mind of, that evil mind that some Nigerians have, that deadly mind. Ghanaians, they don't have it. I've lived with them, I've dwelt with them. I know them and I study them very well. Before I choose to say, yes, I want to live my life with Ghana person, you should have think that I really understand them so much before I take that decision myself. Okay, my adorable people, because it's so annoying. When you acquire that passport, a Ghanaian guy, a Ghanaian citizen, a true soul of the land saw that passport and he asked you, ah, my brother, you're in Nigeria, how come you got this Ghana passport? And you open your mouth to tell that Ghana citizen, it's money now, when you have money, you can got it. I acquired this passport with €1,000. Ha, Nigeria, waiting. That one is not pride, that one is too stupidity. It's not pride. 1,000 euro. Now you see Ghanaians, they are stood up to secure that good name that they have, that good relationship that they have. They are stood up to secure it. They are stood up to expose all of you that is using their passport to constitute nuisance. Not even Dubai. We should just forget that one. Because that one, I will come back to tell you guys what Nigerians are using Ghanaian passport to do in Dubai. All the name of, we don't have no right to Dubai again. So they want to destroy it the way they destroy our own. It will work for you people. Those bad Nigerians, not all, because we have amazing and good intelligent Nigerians. But you see those ones that say they are so smart. I don't know what is wrong with them. Eh? My people, I will believe in you in this judgment. Guys, try and watch to the end and see what they are using Ghana passport to do. Which is very bad because they can draw that nation down the way they did to their own nation. Okay, my people? And I would love to see you all in my next video. Always share this video, okay, my people? As you do so, may God bless you. Stay tuned, my people, and watch and see what is going on. In case you see Ghana, they are telling our Nigerian people to leave. Guys, don't just judge. Try and find out what really leads to that extent. Okay, if you are living in Ghana, you don't have anybody that will stand shorty for you, that will say, yes, he's living in my house, this is what he do. You are not going to get accommodation. They are going to take you back to where you are coming from. If my own country, Nigeria, can do so, I believe Nigeria will be great again. Those population giants of Africa we always claim, that one will just keep it and sweep it under the carpet. Okay, my people, Ghana, that is, you guys are really doing a great job. You guys are so intelligent. Okay, congratulations to you guys once again for really bringing this their secret out. If not, before you know, Europeans all over the world will start talking about you guys the way they talk about us, Nigeria. I love you all, and I love to see you all.
Also advised landlords,
but especially for landlords and property owners, that whenever a non-Ghanaian comes to your premises to rent or to hire, you have to first of all ensure that such a person has resident or stay permit in Ghana. So first you have to ask for his or her immigration status. If that person is undocumented, then we always advise that refer such a person or accompany him or her to the nearest Ghana Immigration Service office for the proper thing to be done. So, for example, if this landlady had gone by the details of the law, I don't think this swap would have been necessary, because then our officers would have already been engaged with these people who are behind us. So once again, I want to reiterate that for our own safety and security as a country, and if you are a landlord or hoteliers, yes, hoteliers, the law also demands that every Friday, you have to send returns of all lodgers in your facility to the Ghana Immigration Service for us to do the necessary.
Hello, bro. Good morning. My name is Daniel. I'm from Ghana, but now I'm living in Dubai. I watched your video considering the passport issue. To be frank and honestly, bro, I wanted to come to the live today and speak about this issue, about the passport issue. In the name of Nigerians, they are using Ghana passport and they are destroying our name here. Seriously and honest to you, bro. Now they are destroying the Ghana, they are destroying the name of the Ghana. Please.
News headline. Nigerian man arrested with 6 fake United Nations passport in Pakistan. A Nigerian national holding 6 fake passport of the United Nations has been arrested in Islamabad. Pakistan Federal Investigation Agency FIA said on Wednesday, December 9. The Nigerian man had visited the Turkish embassy in Islamabad a few days ago and applied for the visa on the fake United Nations passport and ID. During the verification process, the embassy found the documents were counterfeit. Taking swift action on the information provided by the Turkish embassy, the FIA's anti-human trafficking wing apprehended the Nigerian citizen. The FIA, on the suspect's identification, conducted raid at a guest house situated in F8 sector in Islamabad and recovered 6 fake United Nations passports and 7 ID cards. His accomplice, Pakistan national agent Afzal Chaudhry, was also arrested by the FIA. The FIA officials said their mobile phones has been sent for forensic analysis while they were acquiring the details of the bank accounts and assets in the country. Thank you for listening, and don't forget.
Few days ago, the Ghana Immigration Service received some reliable intelligence about the presence of some ECOWAS undocumented citizens around Santor in the East Legon Hills. So for some time now, we have been doing some surveillance around the area. We've sent officers to conduct some surveillance. So this morning, this dawn at around 5 a.m., we embarked on an operation to clamp down on these illegal immigrants. In all, 31 Nigerians were arrested for this dawn operation, and they were brought to our detention center for further investigations. So investigations have been conducted, and currently the service is taking processes to remove them from the country.
Meanwhile, the public relations officer for the Ghana Immigration Service, Superintendent Michael Amwakwata, also advised landlords,
especially for landlords and property owners, that whenever a non-Ghanaian comes to your premises to rent or to hire, you have to first of all ensure that such a person has resident or stay permit in Ghana. So first you have to ask for his or her immigration status. If that person is undocumented, then we always advise that refer such a person or accompany him or her to the nearest Ghana Immigration Service office for the proper thing to be done. So, for example, if this landlady had gone by the details of the law, I don't think this swoop would have been necessary, because then our officers would have already been engaged with these people who are behind us. So once again, I want to reiterate that for our own safety and security as a country, and if you are a landlord or hoteliers, yes, hoteliers, the law also demands that every Friday, you have to send returns of all lodgers in your facility to the Ghana Immigration Service for us to do necessary.